Okay, you click the create page button and you were taken here. And straight away you can see you have six options. Well, obviously you're not a local business, you're not a company. You could well be a brand or product if we think of Harry Potter, but we're not quite there yet. You're not a cause or community. You're either entertainment or an artist, band or public figure. And as we're creating a page about you rather than about your books at the moment, you would click on artist, band or public figure. The next step is to choose a category. And you can see that your category comes up straight away. It's author. Click on author. And your name would be, well, mine seems to be in vogue to kind of just put your initials down. J.K. Rowling or J.R.R. Tolkien or whatever, so I'll do that and I'll click on that to get started. And then it asks me to set up P.S. Rowling's. I always think it sounds a little bit pompous, doesn't it? Just your initials, but there we go. Add a description and website to improve the ranking of your page in search. Okay, that's a good idea. Add a few sentences to tell people what your page is about. This will help it show up in the right search results. You can add more details later. So let's start with doing that. Let's just type in there a little bit about what our page is about. Okay, I've written P.S. Rowling is a writer of dark fantasy fiction for children. I want people straight away to know exactly what it is that I'm about and what they can expect. Okay, go to website. If you have a website, now's the time to type it in. I do have a website, www. There you go, type my website in. And now we need to choose a unique Facebook web address. Okay, so mine will simply be P.S. Rowlands. Is P.S. Rowlands a real celebrity or famous person? Well, sounds good, isn't it? I'll click yes. And will P.S. Rowlands be the authorized and official representation of this celebrity or famous person? Well, again, you click yes. And save info. Now, you don't have to do this, but they ask you to upload a profile picture, so that's entirely up to you. To do that, you'd have to click here. I'm going to upload any picture for the time being. Okay, that looks pretty much, that'll do. Open. And then my picture appears. Well, it's not actually my picture. but it's how I feel very often. And we click on next. Add your page to your favorites to easily access at any time. Okay, so I'll simply add pages and click next. Create an advert to get more people to like your page, but we'll leave that for the time being. In fact, we'll leave that totally, and we'll skip because that's something for another time. And before you advertise anything, I'd like you to read some blog posts I have prepared in the future for you, because you really need your advertising to be laser targeted, and with some tools that are available now, it's possible to do just that. Okay, we'll click skip. And there it is. There it is. How on earth I've got 100 likes, I do not know. And it says then getting around everything you need to manage your pages is in these three tabs, so we click that next. Like, show support the work you've done, setting up your page to like it. Like, okay, I like my page. See at a glance the most important information you need to know about your page, which is on the right here, okay. Invite your email contacts, which you can do if you want to. And then there's my page. That is basically my page. We've got a page there, up and running. I'm actually going to delete this page because that's not me. And it's not particularly what I want to do. But you can see the options you have here. Invite your friends. We've already added a cover photo. So after this video, I'm going to go back to the original page that I showed you. Okay, but that's simply how you set up your page. I hope that helped and didn't confuse you even further. Okay, thanks.